Now it is God who makes both us and you stand firm in Christ. He anointed us, set his seal of ownership on us, and put his Spirit in our hearts as a deposit, guaranteeing what is to come. The word of the Lord. I promise I'll be home by 7. I promise to get all my homework in on time. I promise I'll never do it again. I promise to be faithful as long as we both shall live. You've probably made some promises in your life, and people have probably made promises to you. But it doesn't take long to live here in this world to realize that humans are not very good at keeping promises. We make and we break them all the time. And maybe because of that, you're left in a place where you start to expect promises to be broken. You expect maybe disappointment. You expect people to fail you. Maybe you've been hurt and betrayed and burned enough that promises don't really mean much to you anymore. these types of expectations and results of broken promises, they make sense. Because after all, what is a promise worth if there's no guarantee, if there's no certainty? But what happens when God makes you a promise? Do you expect Him to keep them? Or have we found ourselves in exactly the place where the devil, the father of lies, wants us to be? In a place where we begin to doubt the promises of God, where we hear His truth and we cast it aside as if His faithfulness is like the faithfulness of humans. God, have mercy on us for the times that we have not listened to His truth, for the times that we have not listened to His word, when we have even trashed it and instead taken in the lies of the devil and the lies of the world around us and the lies that we tell ourselves. God, have mercy on us. We need a change. We need to change how we treat God's promises. We need to change how we live. But another piece of the problem is that we can't do it on our own. So God steps in. And here in this reading, He establishes the validity of His promises, and then He makes us some more promises about who you are. He changes our identity from promise rejectors to promise believers. Listen again to what Paul says. No matter how many promises God has made, they're yes in Christ. No matter how many promises, no matter what the promises are, they're yes in Christ. That meaning they're always true. They're always kept. No matter what. Promises like, I have loved you before the creation of the world. Yes. Promises like, I will be with you always. Yes. Promises like, my words bring life and peace and healing. Yes. I sent my son Jesus into this world, who never once doubted my promises, who never once lived in unfaithfulness. For you, yes. I promise that my son Jesus came not only to live for you, but also to die in your place for your sin and for your unfaithfulness. And for your doubt, yes. I promise that I am the King of all kings forever and ever, yes. All His promises are yes. I promise that one day your body, your lowly body, will shine as my son Jesus' body shines now in heaven. Yes. They're all true, they're all kept, they're all from God, and they're all yours. By faith, all of these promises are yours. And God doesn't want this to be a secret, which is exactly why these men are studying to be pastors. Because these promises have come into their lives, and they've seen the effect on their lives, and they want to share it. They want to proclaim it to people. And that's why we're here today. Because in a dark world full of lies and darkness surrounding you, we came to proclaim these promises through songs so that they may ring in your ears today and every day. And maybe some of you here today will consider doing that, being a pastor, proclaiming promises. But promises or not, but being a pastor or not, these promises are yours. And they're also yours to proclaim. Because God has shifted us from promise rejectors to promise believers. Because listen again to what Paul says. It's God who continuously makes you stand firm in Christ. God has already anointed you. God has set you apart as special. God has set His seal, His stamp of ownership on you. He claims you as His. And then he continues. He's put His Spirit in your heart. So God is saying, here are my promises. I want you to believe them. And then he says, I'm going to give you my Spirit and faith so that you believe them. It's all God. It's all because of his love. And if all the promises of God are yes in Christ, then what is there to fear? Listen to the promises of God. Believe them and proclaim them. Amen.
Thank you. Hallelujah.